If you don't learn maths, then you just end up to be an ordinary person. Come, let's become extraordinary with me, Divya, your math facilitator. Today we are going to discuss chapter 3 of class 6, playing with numbers. This is part 2 of the introductory video. If you have not watched part 1 yet, then quickly go and watch it and come so that you'll have a continuity of this chapter. So now let us talk about divisibility rules. Okay, so now if there is a number 30 and if I want to check whether it can be divided by 2 or not, okay, whether it can be divided 2 or not, so what do? I actually divide this number by 2. Yes, 2 ones are 2 and you get 1, 0 carried down, so 2 fives are 10 and the remainder is 0, so you say that 30 is divided by 2 and the answer is 15. Yes, so for every number, if you want to check whether it is divisible or not by a particular number, you have to divide it. Now, without actually dividing this in this way, can we observe some patterns and can we find some divisibility rules or divisibility test? Yes, we can. Now, let us learn about these divisibility rules, which makes our work super easy. Now let us see how can we find whether a number is divisible by 10 or not. Okay, suppose if there is a number 59840. Yes, now is this number divisible by 10? Yes. How? So you'll check for the ones place. Okay, and if in this ones place you find a number 0, then that particular number, that whole number is divisible by 10. Okay, that means in ones place, if you find a number 0, then that number is divisible by 10. Okay, now let us check for 5. Now in ones place, if you find a number 5 or 0, then that particular number is divisible by 5. Okay, for example, 4985. Here in ones place you have 5. Okay, that means this particular number is divisible by 5. Okay, let me take another example, 392. Okay, so here in ones place you have 2, which is not 5 or 0. So this particular number is not divisible by 5. Okay, so in ones place, if there is 5 or 0, then that particular number is divisible by 5. Now let us check for 2. Now for 2, if in ones place there is a number 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that particular number is divisible by 2. Okay, take a number 248193. Okay, so in this particular number in ones place you have 3. Okay, which is not any of these numbers. So this particular number is not divisible by 2. Okay, for example, 49120. This particular number in ones place you find 0, which is one of these numbers. So it is divisible by 2. Yes, you can also observe that in this number, in ones place, since you have 0, it is divisible by 10. It is also divisible by 5. It is also divisible by 2. Now let us learn the divisibility rule for 3. Okay, now let us take a number for this 3, 1, say 5. Okay, so let us check whether 315 is divisible by 3 or not. So you'll add the digits 3 plus 1 plus 5. 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 plus 5 is 9. So here also 9 is a multiple of 3. So this number is also divisible by 3. Now let us talk about divisibility by 6. Now for divisibility by 6, if a number is divisible by both 2 as well as 3, then we can say that that particular number is divisible by 6. Let us take one example, 312. Okay, now 312, you will check for divisibility for 2 as well as 3. Okay, first checking for 2. Okay, so 312, in the ones place you find a number 2, which is divisible by 2. So this particular number is divisible by 2. So put a tick mark. Okay, now checking for 3. Okay, how do you check for 3? You will add the digits. So 3 plus 1 plus 2. 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 is a multiple of 3. So this particular number is also divisible by 3. When 2 ticks, then this number is also divisible by 6. Okay, so 312 is divisible by 6 as well. Now how do we check for the divisibility of 4. So if a number, say a 3-digit number, okay, a 3-digit number or more, for example 482, okay, 3-digit number it is, a 3-digit number or a bigger number, if you want to check whether it is divisible by 4 or not, you will check for the last 2 digits, okay, 1s and 10s place, and you check whether these 2 digits are divisible by 4 or not, okay. So how do you check? 82 divided by 4. 4 2s are 8, 0 2 brought down. So 2 is not divisible, so remainder is 2. That means 82 is not divisible by 4, which means that 482 is also not divisible by 4. Now let us take another number, 520. Okay, so in this case also we will check for the last 2 digits, which is 1s and 10s. You know that 20 is a multiple of 4, yes, that means it is divisible by 4, yes. So this particular number, complete number, is also divisible by 4. So now how do we check if a number is divisible by 8 or not? Okay, so if a number has 4 or more digits, so we use this method to check whether it is divisible by 8 or not, okay. So let us take one number, 7512. Okay, so you will check for the last 3 digits. In case of 4, we were checking for the last 2 digits. Yes, so here we will check for the last 3 digits. Okay, so 512, we will check if this 512 is divisible by 8 or not. Okay, 6 are 48, and when you subtract, you get 3, and 2 brought down, so 32. 4s are 32. Which means 512 is divisible by 8, yes? So this complete number is also divisible by 8. Now let us talk about divisibility by 9. It is similar to divisibility by 3. What did we do there? We have added up the digits and we found whether the sum is a multiple of 3 or not. Here also we are going to add the digits, okay? Let us take one example, 8125. Clear? So now we will add the digits. Nothing but 8 plus 1 plus 2 plus 5. So 8 plus 1 9, 9 plus 2 11, 11 plus 5 is 16. Okay, now you'll check whether 16 is a multiple of 9 or not. So you find that 16 is not a multiple of 9. So this particular number is not divisible by 9. Now let us take another example, 2655. Here also we'll add the digits. So 2 plus 6 plus 5 plus 5. So 2 plus 6 is 8, 8 plus 5 is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18. Now 18 is a multiple of 9. So this particular number is divisible by 9. Now if you want to check if a number is divisible by 11 or not, it is a little different process than the other divisibility rules, okay? So firstly, let us take a number, 581. Okay, so firstly we'll write the place values, ones, tens, hundreds. Okay, so ones place, I'm marking it as 1, okay, the first place from right. Okay, and this will be 2, second place from right, and this is 3. As we already learned even and odd numbers, so you can see that this tens place is even place and hundreds and ones place are odd place. Yes, so this is 1, 2, 3, where 2 is even, so this place is even place, and these two places, 1 and 3, are odd places. Yes, so we'll firstly add the even places. Okay, here since you have only one even place, so it is 8, the sum is 8, so you write sum of even places is 8. Okay, now let us add the odd places. Now sum of odd places is, so here you have 5 in odd place plus you have 1 in odd place, okay, which is 6. Now what do we do? After getting the sum of even places and sum of odd places, you subtract these two answers, okay? So now the difference between the even and odd place you find, okay? So even place is 8 and in odd place you got 6. So 8 minus 6 is 2. Now this difference, it has to be either 0 or a multiple of 11 so that this particular number is divisible by 11, okay? Here the difference is 2, which is neither 0 nor a multiple of 11. So this particular number is not divisible by 11. So taking one more example, 61,809. Let us check if it is divisible by 11 or not. So how do we do it? We write the odd and even places first. So I suggest you to number it from the right side so that you don't confuse. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And you know that 2 and 4 are even places and the rest of the remaining places are odd. Okay. So we'll first sum up. Sum of even places is you have 0 and then you have 1 in even places. Okay. So adding these two digits you get 1. Now sum of odd places. Now sum of odd places. Here in odd place you have 9 plus you have 8 plus you have 6. Okay. So 9 plus 8 is 17. 17 plus 6 is 23. Okay. Now what is the next step? We find the difference of the even and odd places. Okay. So in even place you got 1 and in odd place you got 23. So difference is 23 minus 1, which is 22. And you know that 22 is a multiple of 11. So this particular number is divisible by 11. Come, let's check our understanding with do it yourself. So check if 49128 is divisible by 2 and then 5 and then 10 or not. Okay. Also check if 4921 is divisible by 6 or not. And then check if 5445 is divisible by 11 or not. This brings us to the end of this video. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. The links I have left in the description box below. You can also give me your valuable suggestions and comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.